always stood for power to correct, power to prevent, and power to get things done. She has been running two NGOs successfully, India Vision Foundation and Navjyoti India Foundation, which reach out to marginalized sections of the society in the field of education, skills development in urban slums and backward areas, including prisons. Her achievements are indeed innumerable.
दीपक बोलता नहीं, उसका प्रकाश परिचय देता है। दीपक बोलता नहीं, उसका प्रकाश परिचय देता है। अंधकार के प्रभाव को जड़ से दूर कर देता है। तो आइए दीप प्रज्वलन के माध्यम से हम अपने कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत करते हैं।
ये भी बंद करो।
I would like to humbly request our principal ma'am to extend a cordial welcome to Dr. Kiran Bedi ma'am.
You missed the welcome.
Namaste, ma'am. It's such an honor to have you today on this platform with us. And our children are so fortunate that today you are addressing them. Ma'am, as I welcome you, there is no introduction that can match your stature. But I would just like to add here that in 2015, when you came to our school, you addressed the audience. You said one very vital thing, and I can never forget. It comes to my memory more now. You said that of all the things that we have to prepare our children for, we need to prepare them for the uncertainties that lie ahead. And look what we are facing today.
My God, I didn't know that.
Yes, ma'am, you said that in 2015 in our school. And today it sounds so very relevant that the education that we are imparting has to become significant in terms of preparing our children for anything and everything. So I would not take any more time of the audience who are so eager to listen to you. I would hand over the mic to you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, for joining us and guiding our children.
So wonderful. How wonderful. Was that Priyanka?
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am, that's Priyanka Barara, principal of the school.
Thank you, carry on. Yeah, I remember that.
Yes, ma'am. So ma'am, today, like we are encouraging our children to take forward the message of our Honorable Prime Minister that we all have to become self-reliant. Therefore, we thought it's extremely vital if you address them on this particular topic and guide them that they as students, how they can contribute towards making our country self-reliant, because children tend to think that this is something that someone else has to take up. But I think being self-reliant comes from the very point that each one of us contributes towards this self-reliant thought and work towards it. And it's at this formative stage, if we can have solid foundation towards this, we can help our country become self-reliant.
Thank you. You know, self-reliance has many meanings. Self-reliant, to my mind, has many meanings. It has a big meaning and a small meaning. But the small meaning has a bigger result, individually, one-to-one. And the bigger meaning of self-reliance is a national asset. It benefits the whole country as a whole. Now, let's look at the armed forces. When we go in for self-reliance in, let's say, arms manufacturing, right? We don't import heavy weapons from overseas. We are saving crores of rupees of the country. And when those crores of rupees are kept behind in this country of dollars, we are better off in foreign exchange. So it's a large self-reliance. When we are substituting our imports by exports, like for instance, before we went to COVID, we were importing ventilators. We were importing the personal protection equipments. We were importing certain medical equipments. At that time, it didn't look like it's very tough. It didn't seem very urgent. But you see, when we needed so much, or so many ventilators at that time, remember, I read in the newspaper, the ventilator, the Maruti company, in its own same car manufacturing, started also make ventilators because we were short of ventilators. I remember even in Pondicherry, earlier when COVID thing was very, very high, there was a crisis of shortage of ventilators. And therefore, there was something. So when countries started to make ventilators and PPE equipment, it started to export. What did it do? It became Atmanirbhar. Pehle, we were Bahar Nirbhar. Bahar se Nirbhar. Then we became Atmanirbhar. And now we have our own PPE equipments. We have our own ventilators. And now we are also exporting it. So what I'm saying is Atmanirbhar can look at my mind into two portions. One is at the big scale, at the national scale, as I've just explained to you as an example, because something which comes immediately to your notice. And after a long time, India has started to open up, start to make the ordnance factories also in PPP mode, where public-private partnership would come and manufacture its own small weapons. So I'm only giving you one example of saving billions of dollars. There's a smaller scale of Atmanirbhar. And that Atmanirbhar is where we buy our own small scale issues from the small people. From the small people. Now, when I say small people, know when the Prime Minister talked about khadi, saying sab jane hafte mein, mahine mein ek khadi ka kapra khareedna. Ek khadi ka kapra khareedna, chahe khadi ka toil, khadi ka towel hai, ya aapka shirt hai, kuch ya chota wrap up shawl hai, ya rumal bhi hai. क्योंकि खादी कौन बनाता है? वो व्यक्ति जो आत्मनिर्भर के लिए स्ट्रगल कर रहा है, वो आत्मनिर्भरता की स्ट्रगल कर रहा है. अमीर नहीं आत्मनिर्भरता की स्ट्रगल कर रहा है. एक है नेशनल आत्मनिर्भरता, एक है इंडिविजुअल आत्मनिर्भरता. मैं ये कहूंगी इस दिवाली में हम लोग इस वक्त इंडिविजुअल आत्मनिर्भरता की तरफ जाएं, और करोड़ों रुपए का जो हमने खरीदना है वो हम छोटे स्केल छोटी दुकानदार से खरीदें. इस बारी बड़े से ना जाएं, मॉल में नहीं जाएं, हम छोटी दुकानदार में जाएं, दिए बनाने वाली पर जाएं, छोटे खिलौने वाले के पास जाएं, क्योंकि उसके लिए वो पैसा आत्मनिर्भरता देगा, उसको सेल्फ रिलायंस देगा, क्योंकि उसका पैसा, उसकी इनकम बढ़ गई. सो अगर आपने इस बारी आत्मनिर्भरता करनी है दिवाली की में, और उसमें हमने अपने बच्चों ने अपना रोल प्ले करना है, तो मेरी सलाह ये है आप लोकल को बनाओ वोकल. गो बैक टू लोकल परचेजेस लाइक दियाज, कैंडल्स, एनी अदर थिंग विच यू वर लुकिंग फॉर, कैलेंडर्स, पिक्चर्स. गो फॉर द लोकल स्मॉल हॉकर, जिसके पास वो है तो उसके पास, और उसके पास से आपने हॉक वो नहीं करना, गैगलिंग नहीं करनी. उसने कहा कि 10 रुपए का है, तो आपने ये नहीं कहना नहीं नहीं 9 रुपए का ठीक है, मैं 3 ले लूंगी तो 18 रुपए दे दो. नो, उसको 10 रुपए के 10 रुपए दे दो. और अगर और भी आत्मनिर्भरता की तरफ जाना है, तो अगर फीमेल सेलर है, अगर औरत बेच रही है कुछ, तो जरूर औरत को प्रेफर करो, क्योंकि जो औरत से आप खरीदोगे, औरत की कमाई 100% फैमिली को जाती है. 100% पुरुष, अच्छे पुरुष 100% फैमिली को देते हैं, यूजलेस पुरुष कहीं और भी खर्च देते हैं. तो इसलिए मेरी सलाह कि वो हमने अब लोकल को वोकल बनाना है. इसलिए हमने अभी की आगे की जो खासकर फेस्टिवल की परचेजेस हैं, और वो करोड़ों रुपए की परचेज होगी. सभी जिन्होंने कुछ ना कुछ जरूर खरीदना है, चाहे वो मिठाई खरीदनी है या कपड़ा खरीदना है या कोई गिफ्ट खरीदनी है, तो आप उस पर जाओ जहां एक छोटी दुकानदार है. दुकानदार छोटी दुकान, ना कि मोटी बड़ी दुकानदार. आई थिंक फिर हम लोग उस पर भी जा सकते हैं, आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट में भी. आर्ट एंड क्राफ्ट भी हाथ के वो लोग होते हैं जो कि लोकल होते हैं और वो क्रिएटिविटी क्रिएट करते हैं। सो आपने आत्मनिर्भरता की बोली, मैंने एक बड़ा उदाहरण दे दिया आपको वेपन का, छोटा उदाहरण दे दिया इस वक्त दिवाली का। क्यों नहीं हम लोग इस वक्त ये इस पद करें तो हम इमीडिएटली हम आत्मनिर्भरता, कई गरीब फैमिलीज जो कोविड की वजह से अपना अपना काम खो गए और उनको नुकसान हुआ, क्योंकि लॉकडाउन में नुकसान किसको होता है, उसको जो कि रोज की कमाई रोज करता है, रोज खाता है सब्जी। सो सब्जी खरीदी है ना, तो आप उसके पास जाओ, छोटी दुकानदार के पास। सब्जी भी खरीदनी है तो आपने छोटी दुकानदार पे जाओ। सो इफ यू स्टार्ट बिकमिंग कॉन्शियस कि मैंने एक चीज खरीदनी है जिसमें वो व्यक्ति के लिए दो रुपए भी मेरे कमाने से दो 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 रुपए करके उसके पास खाने पीने के लिए हो जाएगा। टू मी दिस इज अनदर वे ऑफ आत्मनिर्भरता। आत्मनिर्भरता डजंट ओनली मीन प्रोडक्टिविटी, आत्मनिर्भरता ऑल्सो मीन्स वेयर योर परचेज इज मेकिंग द अदर पर्सन मोर सेल्फ रिलायंट ऑल्सो। तो आप तो आत्म, आपके पास तो पैसा है ही खर्चने को, आपने उससे खरीदा जिसके पास आपका पैसा भी हो पैसा खर्चने के लिए, क्योंकि वह भी जब खर्चेगा उसके बच्चों को भी उसको सेहत भी मिलेगी और बच्चों को भी कुछ पॉकेट मनी मिलेगी, वो भी बच्चे आपकी दिवाली का एंजॉय कर सकेंगे। विद दिस शॉर्ट आंसर आई थॉट अगर बच्चे ये भी मैसेज आज इस मेरे वेबिनार से ले जाएं कि इस दिवाली में हम अपने मम्मी डैडी को बोलेंगे मामा ढूंढो कहाँ फीमेल सेलर है, कहाँ छोटी दुकान है, जाओ वहां से हम लेंगे, हम उसी से खरीदेंगे, उससे हैगलिंग नहीं करेंगे बल्कि उसको जो मांगे उसको देंगे, और साथ में सब लोगों को बताएंगे कि हमने ये, और खासकर ऐसी चीज भी खरीदें जो हाथ की बनी हो, जो हाथ की बनी हो, जैसे दिए हाथ के बने हुए हैं, खादी हाथ की बनी है, आर्किटेक्चर खिलौने हाथ के बने हुए हैं। अगर हम हाथ की हैंडीक्राफ्ट पे भी जाएं तो आई थिंक इट विल मेक स्प्रेड मोर आत्मनिर्भरता, एंड इस फेस्टिवल सीजन में घर घर में खुशहाली जाएगी, घर घर में दिवाली जाएगी। दिस वुड बी प्रियंका वुड माई शॉर्ट मैसेज ऑफ आत्मनिर्भरता ऑन द दिवाली ईव, एंड व्हाइल आई विश यू ऑल अ वेरी वेरी हैप्पी दिवाली, मे दिस दिवाली ब्रिंग ग्रेट डील ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी, कनेक्ट विद दैट पर्सन जिसके आप कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट करें, उसके घर में भी दिवाली खुशियां लाए। थैंक यू प्रियंका।
थैंक यू मैम फॉर दिस वंडरफुल एड्रेस। Our students would like to ask a few questions also, if you permit.
Please do.
Yeah. So, can you start with your question first?
Yes, ma'am. Namaste, ma'am. Ansh Goyal this side.
Yes.
Ma'am, the government is promoting local goods. However, they are comparatively more expensive due to low skills of production, which might affect lower income group families. So what is the government's remedy for this?
Government is promoting what and why? What is more expensive? Come again.
Ma'am, I have local goods. Ma'am, for example, if I take the example of the toys industry, a large proportion of that market is under the domain of the Chinese. Whereas Indian
toys... You are not going to buy anything foreign. I think that rule is very clear. Kam khareed lenge, lekin hum imported cheez nahi khareedenge. Ye aapko ye leke chalna hai. Ye... आप हमारा भी जिम्मेवार, आफ्टर ऑल चाइनीज गुड्स इसलिए आए क्योंकि सस्ते थे और हमने खूब खरीदे, इसीलिए हमने प्रमोट किया ना, तो हम कहेंगे हम कम खरीद लेंगे लेकिन हम अपना भारतीय प्रोडक्ट ही खरीदेंगे। ये अगर हम लोग ये फीलिंग स्वदेशी की फीलिंग लाएंगे जैसे हमने फ्रीडम मूवमेंट में किया था तो ये कामयाब हो जाएगा, ऑटोमेटिकली उसकी डिमांड खत्म हो जाएगी तो वो प्रोडक्ट नहीं आएंगे और वो प्रोडक्ट भी हेल्दी नहीं है और वो क्वालिटी में भी सफर करते हैं, लेकिन क्वालिटी भी अगर अच्छी होती वो भी होती तो भी मैं क्यों लूँ, नहीं लूंगी चाहे मेरे 4 रुपए और भी जाए। सो आई थिंक वी हैव टू बी ऑल्सो इन पेट्रियोटिक इन आवर परचेजेस।
ओके थैंक यू मैम।
हु हैज द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन?
यस मैम। नमस्ते मैम, दिस साइड इज रिचार्ड एंड माय क्वेश्चन इज मैम, will there be any competition left among industries if we support and give high importance to local products?
What did he say?
Yes, ma'am. My bad question is, ma'am, will there be any competition left among industries if we support and give high importance to local products?
Vishal, no. Will there be competition left among different industries if we give support and importance to only one. Look, if we, at the moment, I'm not talking of you buying heavy machinery. I'm at the moment at a level, I'm trying to speak at a level which we can all afford. You see, I'm not talking of buying cars right now. I'm not talking buying at the moment. At the moment, I'm speaking to young students where you can immediately play a role in the immediate present and the future. And the immediate present and future is, what are you going to buy for Diwali? Let me talk about that. You see, there are many levels of discussions. I don't want to get into a level of discussion which is theoretical and also theoretical and maybe more of, what is it called, intellectual or practical. No, intellectual. I'm going to practical aspect. Tum sab ne gaadi nahi khareedi. Tum sab ne washing machine nahi jaake khareedi. Wo mommy daddy ka kaam hai. लेकिन तुम हर बच्चे ने, हर स्टूडेंट ने कुछ ना कुछ जरूर खरीदना अपने फ्रेंड्स के लिए, अपने लिए. उस वक्त आप लोकल प्रोडक्ट खरीदना, ढूंढ के खरीदना, जो मैंने आपको बोला है. तो ये कोई इंडस्ट्री को नुकसान पहुंचाने वाली नहीं है. ये फिर इंडस्ट्री खरीदेगी इनसे और उसको नया पैकिंग करके बेचेगी. वो अपने तरीके से बेचेगी, तुम अपने तरीके से खरीदो. किसी को नुकसान होने वाला नहीं है, बल्कि आप परचेजिंग पावर उस गरीब की भी बना इंक्रीज कर रहे हो जिससे आप खरीद रहे हो. So nobody's a loser. Don't worry about that. At the moment, you determine yourself that jab maine khareedna hai, to maine is waqt ab local hi khareedna hai. You understand? Jaise detergent hai, jaise kai soaps hai, kai ji badi achhe soap bana rahi. Kai agar acha quality aapka haath nahi kharab karti, to aap wo try karke dekho. Try and do it. Detergents bhi wo bana rahe. Lekin kai cheeze kapda hai, kapda aapko health wise nuksan nahi karega. Try and do that. Even Ayurveda product would be very useful for immunity. Even your, no wonder Ayurveda products, I don't want to mention anybody's name, but they are good for immunity. You know, when you buy products of this kind of, which have the Indian cultural linkage, but it is also value, why not use them?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I think Yojit wants to ask his next question. Yojit?
Namaste, ma'am. It's an honor to be talking to you. I want to ask that, will not promoting this campaign isolate India from global markets? As in, will it not affect our relation with other countries?
You are not, when you do, in fact, if the moment you promote, I believe, KVK, moment you promote Khadi, it's pure cotton. It's good, clean, healthy yarn. On the contrary, you are not isolating it. You are probably even expanding it, and others will buy it. You are promoting the product because you are modeling it. When you start modeling in your khadi and in your cottons made in India or printed made in India or hand done in India, and you model and you feel proud of it, as students you flaunt it, you are actually promoting a product which will improve your exporting, isn't it, Arjun?
Yes, we model for khadi all the time. And we,
Rajnivas models for khadi all the time. So we product, so when visibility, look, if our, on the media, if some of our media people and who they come and they say, we are proud, I'm wearing this of Indian, you think it will isolate us or promote us? It will promote us. So therefore, it doesn't, on the contrary, it will make you more self-reliant and self-atamnirbhar rather than dependent. And it will bring you more, it will improve your savings of foreign exchange in this country.
Thank you, ma'am. We'll surely bring it in implementation.
Yes, Mita. Well, I'm trying to give you an answer which is immediately practical to you in the immediate next 2 weeks.
Thank you, ma'am. And it looks very, very relevant also considering the age group of our children and the stage we are in currently right now. Very relevant suggestions, ma'am. Ma'am, we have next child, Anish. Anish, you have your question?
Yes, ma'am. Good evening, ma'am. My name is Anish. Ma'am, it gives me immense happiness that I'm talking to you. So, ma'am, my question is, what do you think, how long it will take us to be completely self-reliant when we go ahead with vocal for local policy?
It will not take us long. if you ask me, our attitude if it changes, कि हम सब्जी वाला सब्जी उससे खरीदे जो सब्जी उगा रही है, सीधा उसी से ले, वो छाबी वाला जो आता है उसी से ले। हमारे पास दिल्ली में दो मार्केट्स, एक आई ऑल्सो मैं भी गलती करती हूँ, मैंने गलती करनी बंद कर दी, एक आता है रेडी वाला घर और एक आती खान मार्केट। खान मार्केट में प्राइस डबल है, और जब मैं खान मार्केट में जाती हूँ तो मुझे, मैं देखती भी नहीं, वो सीधा मुझे देता है थिंकिंग कि मुझे सब कुछ ठीक मिलेगा, बट इट्स डबल द प्राइस। लेकिन जो जो रेडी वाला आ रहा है, जो छाबड़ी वाला आ रहा है, वो अगर उससे खरीदूं और मैं चुन के खरीद लूं, आई स्टिल गेट द सेम थिंग। इवन इफ आई गेट द सेम प्राइस, मेरा रेडी वाला हेल्पफुल रहेगा। सो मेरा, तुम्हारा क्वेश्चन क्या था बेटा?
How long it will take us to be complete?
Oh, it will not take us long.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now, I'm not talking now. Why it wouldn't take us long? See, how long did it take us to make up, become self-sufficient in ventilators? How long did it take us in PPE? How long did it take us to set up these laboratories? Nothing. It was nothing but a crisis. The point, it proved a point that India is capable to rise to any occasion, provided you see an emergency.
Okay,
and that is what will give your engineering subjects much more relevance. In fact, this change and shift towards more of self-reliant Indian goods will make engineering subjects much more valuable now. You know what? Engineering colleges were closing down. In the recent past, engineering colleges were closing down. Now engineering colleges will have greater value. And various other kinds of, and also computer value of artificial intelligence and others. It will become, make you more self-reliant.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Namaste, ma'am. Ma'am, my name is Pankhuri. Ma'am, my question is, how will promoting local goods help us to become a self-reliant country in future?
Okay, you tell me the answer.
Ma'am, basically, if we will be promoting...
Well, all you girls and boys, I know you have the answer. I want to listen to you. Maybe you got better answers. You tell me.
Ma'am, basically, if we will be promoting the local goods, it will be benefit for us to compete other countries in future.
Tell me how.
Like, ma'am, for example...
Look, artificial jewelry is another example. India is very good in artificial jewelry. Our women do a lot of hand beadwork. So these kind of little markets, they trinkets will start going into those flea markets of Southeast Asian countries. So I'm not saying that, I'm just thinking of off the cuff a product. But as you live, you start realizing what can be of value, you can and start selling online. You will see, start selling online. And even an age group of yours can sell online.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
You can earn your pocket money by selling online.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Also, if you could just throw some light on the importance of vocational training that generally people do not opt for. And I personally feel that vocational training can play a significant role in making each one of us self-reliant. Rather than looking for employment, we will be generating employment. If you could just, ma'am, talk a little bit about that, I think it would create awareness amongst parents.
This is called Hunar. सब में अंदर भगवान ने हुनर भेजा है, दे के भेजा है, सबके पास हुनर है। वो अपना हुनर को पहचानो कि मेरे अंदर, मैं कौन से हुनर से बॉर्न हूँ। जैसे कोई सिंगर है, कोई डांसर है नेचुरली, कोई हार्ट का क्रिएटिव है, कोई कोई किसी के पास हैंड स्किल है, किसी के पास म्यूजिक स्किल है, किसी के पास इंस्ट्रूमेंट स्किल है, किसी को बनाने की स्किल है, किसी के पास गेम की स्किल है, किसी के पास गाने की स्किल है। भगवान ने हर एक को कोई ना कोई स्किल दिया है, हम पहचानते ही नहीं। लेकिन हुनर सीखा भी जाता है। एक हुनर है हम जन्म से, एक हुनर है जो सीखते हैं। स्कूलों में वोकेशनल स्किल जरूर सीखो, जो भी स्किल देते हैं ये आप सीखो, क्योंकि आपको ये देखना है। एक तो स्किल इज लाइक अ स्टैंड, इवन कुकिंग इज अ स्किल। कुकिंग वेल, बेकिंग साउथ इंडियन फूड, चाइनीज फूड, दीज आर ग्रेट। Making only soups, making all kinds of rice, this is a hunar and this is a skill. Ab mujhe ye batao, ye aisi skill hai jo aapko sari umar chahiye, aur aap isko sell bhi kar sakte ho, रेसिपीज बना के बुक्स भी लिख सकते हो, आप डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन भी कर सकते हो. सो आई एम सेइंग हर एक के पास स्किल है, वो स्किल का इस्तेमाल करें. कोई इसमें बड़ी छोटी स्किल नहीं है. इट इज एवरी स्किल हैज इट्स ओन वैल्यू. इट इज द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ ऑल दीज स्किल्स व्हिच मेक योर लाइफ रिच एंड टेस्टी एंड फुल ऑफ वैरायटी एंड कलर्स. सो स्कूलों में अब आपका नया एजुकेशन प्रोग्राम में स्किल डेवलपमेंट विल बी एसेंशियल फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 9. इट वॉज सपोज टू हैव कम मच अर्लियर. When 10 plus 2 was started, I remember it was for vocational skill. But somehow or the other, our policies went wrong. We did not pay attention to it. So when your schools introduce a vocational skill, go and learn it. And art and craft training and all these classes, extracurricular, go and learn. Go to this music class. Go to the dance class. Go to the sports class. Go to these classes. You should be happy in that your school has those skills. And the more skills they have, volunteer. Skill learning, say, you never know. Aap usi pe, do you know ek baar, kai yahan par bade startups ne pata kya hunar diya? They are taking away garbage and making it into manure. That's a skill. And it's a startup program of crores of rupees. Because har ek ghar mein garbage hai. Wo kya kar rahe hain? Garbage ko katha karke, manuring kar rahe hain, usko separate kar rahe hain, aur uske upar they are a startup of crores of rupees. They're becoming now multinationals because environment is a very major issue. Agriculture is a skill. Plantation of trees is a skill. Floriculture is a skill. Everything is a skill. It is every, hum usko gardener bolte, aap kahenge horticulturist. You call it horticulturist. Actually, the person is doing gardening. But he's a phoolon ki decoration. कईयों के बड़ा हाथ से फ्रूट वो बड़े अच्छे आर्टिफिशियल फ्लावर्स बनाते हैं एंड दे कॉल इट फ्लोरिस्ट. तुम कहोगे ये तो छोटा सा. नो, इट इज नॉट छोटा मोटा. जो आपके पास स्किल है उसका पूरा फायदा उठाओ और लर्न करो. स्कूल ऑफर जब करे उसकी ध्यान से बात सुनो और सीखो. मैं आपको बता दूं, इवन न्यूज़पेपर सेलिंग इन द मार्केट इन द नेबर एज अ लर्निंग, इवन डूइंग ट्यूशन ट्रेनिंग फॉर द अनदर, even babysitting, these are all skills. What makes you think they're small or big? You got time? So your neighbor needs help, say, auntie, I will help. I will sit and study with this boy. Aap jao, apne kaam, I have a holiday today. I'll sit with your boy for 2 hours. I do babysit. Maybe they will give you some pocket money out of it. What's the problem? You're learning to babysit. You're learning to cook. You're learning to clean. Aren't there factories? Are there many companies which have hired for house cleaning? When you live overseas, they come in a car and they, in 15 minutes, half an hour, they do vacuum cleaning and they do everything cleaning and they charge you £80. I've seen this happen. £80 they get for all vacuum cleaning and cleaning, and they come in a car with these equipment. So are they called swachhta? They are doing house cleaning. They are house. They give themselves all fancy names, but they are the entrepreneurs. Where did they learn? Some learned it at home. Some learned it from school. Some learned it by themselves. Today, anything which is a need of the hour, and you can become its own entrepreneur. It's called being entrepreneurs, and also a starting self-employment. And this is how you learn nursery teaching, nursery rhyming. You can. Every family today needs this kind of work. So you can be small boy teacher, girls teacher. So it's like earning your pocket money. The more you want, some children, like I was when I was growing up, I used my hard work to earn a scholarship. Because why? Because I wanted to be self-reliant. I wanted to pay my own fee. I didn't want to depend on my parents. I wanted to see whether I'm capable to earn a scholarship. To me, that was hunar. From scholarship to merit list, from merit list to the UPSC, from UPSC to the Indian Police Service. That was also skill. That was a skill of merit. But I also remember when I finished with my graduation and I had 3 months time before my master's, I went to teach. I went to a school and I said, can I teach your children? They said, how much time you have? I said, I've got 3 months. And I earned for those 3 months by becoming a nursery teacher for 3 months. as to go on a cycle, go to the school, sing those nursery rhymes, play with the children, and I earned 30 rupees. My first salary for earning was 30 rupees. I still remember with so much of pride that my first earning in my life was a nursery teacher. It's different what I did with 30 rupees. I immediately spent all the 30 rupees I wanted to buy presents for my mother, my father, my sister, and I earned. I learned a skill to be self-reliant. So being self-reliant in whatever you do, I think it's a great skill. You can say, mommy, I will do this work for you. You pay me 100 rupees of extra pocket money. I'll do this work for you. Mommy will say, okay. Mommy ka computer ko manage karo. It's a skill. Manage your papa mama's computer issues. It's a skill. They will pay you pocket money. They pay up somebody from outside, you know better to correct it. You say, acha mom, I will do this. You give me extra pocket. That's a skill. It's an IT skill. So, ye nahi sochte ke ye to mujhe aata. Tumhare sabke paas koi na koi hunar hai. Aap skill learn karo, usko develop karo. Or you never know. Usi ke wajah se, after all, jitne Bill Gates aur ye jitne bane na, ye jobs, ye sare car parking garages se bane hai. Inhone apni skill car garages se kari. Even Kiran Majumdar Shaw started from a car garage. And she's today India's richest woman in biotechs. She also started her startup company, Biocon, from a garage. So we have these examples, both Indian and foreign. So never think, main shuru se MD ban jaun, main shuru se chairman ban. Nahi, start from being an apprentice of anything you're easy with. Okay?
Thank you, ma'am. What a wonderful insight, and your examples are so inspiring. I'm sure some of my students are definitely going to take a lead and start helping the younger ones. One more question, ma'am, from Vani Sachdeva, where she also has something related to what you have spoken. Vani, please go ahead.
Namaste, ma'am. My name is Vani. My question is, how can we, being seniors, inspire our juniors in Vocal for Local?
You know, it should be compulsory and mandatory that from the moment you are in the 8th class onwards, you will take a class of the 2nd standard. You will go to the 1st standard. 10th standard must go to the 2nd and the 3rd standard. 12th standard must come to 4th and 5th standard. They will keep the fundamentals afresh. They will keep it revised. Their mathematics revised, their civics revised, their geography, their science, their math, everything revised. Why should we not do it? And what will happen is, when the elder goes and educates the younger, do you know what all you're learning without any additional cost? You're learning to communicate. You're learning to concentrate. You're learning to deliver. You're learning to engage. You're learning to build networks and team spirit. You're learning self-leadership because you are delivering. You are learning to listen to yourself. You're organizing your own thoughts. You're learning to prepare a lesson plan. You're learning to interact. Tell me, how will you learn these skills if you don't do this? If you start doing all the classes, 10th standard or for 9th standard, should go down and have a class. And I can tell you, you will all do better. The children will listen to you even more. Let the teacher listen to you and then improve you. So you observe the teacher, how she teaches you. And then just as certain other things are becoming compulsory, I would say teaching the junior by will be compulsory. The college should come down to the school level. The university should come to the college level. If the university comes to college level, college goes to school level goes to primary level, the kind of interaction it will happen, the kind of environment it will happen, and we are trying to teach you leadership. This is what leadership is all about. Leadership is organizing yourself, leading the way, showing the way, preparing the way, and communicating the way. And children will love you. So as a small teacher, you're getting loved. You're getting loved. What else do you want? How can you get love otherwise without giving? So what is the biggest thing you're learning as a child, as a girl, is giving. You're learning to give, not take. You're learning to give. So when you learn the spirit of giving, of knowledge, which is selfless, you've learned a character trait. You cannot give up this habit of giving, because the moment you give like this, you get addicted to giving this joy. Look, I'm addicted to this. Otherwise, why would I take these webinars? Tell me, I'm addicted to this. I'm addicted to giving. Otherwise, out of my busy schedule, I can say, thank you very much, I'm okay. But no, I find my time, because I know by giving, I get joy. Look, by the way, the main manner in which I'm communicating to you and to all of your school and children, we do Friday book show here. You know, Raj Nivas does a book show every Friday, 5 p.m., book reading. Book reading, can you believe it? Raj Nivas does a book reading show every 5 p.m., every Friday, 5 o'clock. And children write to Asha Gupta. She is on online. They write to her and we pick up 6 students and we do book reading with them. And there are hundreds of others who listen. Why am I doing it? Because we see joy in giving. What is the point? Raj Nivas does it for all adults and elders. What about children? Children don't come to connect with Raj Nivas. So we connect with Raj Nivas virtually every week. And through webinars, when we get such like webinar invitations, we find the way, we squeeze the way, we adjust the way so that we are available for you. Thrice a week, we have dedicated our time in Raj Nivas only for webinars. We find an hour in 3 days in a week, webinars, education. Why? Because we find there is so much joy in giving. Now, this joy in giving started from the time when I was your age. When you get into this habit of giving, then you continue with this habit of giving and you find your own way. As I grew up, my two foundations, I think Neetu Sharma Joshi connected with you. Neetu is the director of Navjoti India Foundation. Do you know she educates thousands of children in a Bhavana slums and etc. Thousands of children. Can you believe it? Where did that Navjoti India Foundation come in my life? Out of giving. Even when I became a police officer, I opened a foundation to benefit the poor children for schooling. It was giving. So the moment you get into the habit of giving as a child, you never give up. And when you do not give up giving, you stay happy all your life. You will search to give. So learn this habit. Your question is the best question which I've answered now by now is, how can I, as a child, grown-up child, do something? By giving. Look for your family within, your neighborhood within, your domestic staff within, your school within. Everywhere you get a chance, go ahead. But when you grow up, then you will find a way to create. You'll create societies, you'll create institutions, you'll help out to the others, you'll go out, stretch out for internships. Now internships are going to be compulsory in your new education policy. You will have to do internships. Entrepreneurship, it's all practical learning. In Germany, that's what they do. After a particular school, after school, 1 year, no education, no senior. Go and learn in a factory. That's why the Germans are far ahead of time. They'll go work 1 year in a factory. No college. Go first hands-on learning. If we do that, imagine 300 to 400 million youth, all hand-skilled, learning to use their hands. And do you know what? Everyone can employ 10 people. When you become self-employed, you benefit 10 people. So rather than looking for jobs, as Priyanka is saying, look for giving jobs. And you can even have your own company. You can become the chief and you can have 5 girls, children, boys employed. So, okay, I'll give you 50, I'll give you 100. We will do this. And we can do small selling on the market, in the market. What's the problem? You're learning entrepreneurship. There are no shortcuts to learning without doing. So the more you do, more you come together, the more you become team spirit, collaborative, the more networking all your life, this friendship bonding is more permanent and lasting than friends you will make later. Friends made in school and college are more lasting than because they are selfless, they are loving. They're caring. They're full of joyful memories. This is a time to build this kind of friendship. Okay, Priyanka.
Thank you so much, ma'am. This has been such an enlightening session, and I'm going to, my children are definitely going to write to Asha, ma'am, so that they also become sometime a part of your book reading. I'm going to share her email address if she permits. So this is going to be absolutely a long-lasting tradition, I think, for as long as you do. I saw those book reading sessions only, ma'am. That's why I've been requesting Neetu that we would also like to have an opportunity with you. And really, it's commendable how you are taking out time for everyone who connects with you. It is so beautiful. Even this concept of teaching the younger ones, I know in Navjyoti also, students who pass out from Navjyoti, they come back and teach the younger children.
They do a Gurukul. Ask Neetu to explain to you the Gurukul concept.
Yes, ma'am. Well, I'm aware. I've seen it. I've been to Navjyoti and I've seen how nicely it is being done, and the efforts Navjyoti is making is totally, totally commendable. They stand up to any occasion. Whenever there is a need in the surrounding, even further away, they stand up to it. And this is really commendable. I am constantly in touch with the team there, and I appreciate whatever they are doing, always.
Thank you so
much. The vision is all yours. The vision is all yours. And we are so happy that we could steal a few moments from you on this very, very busy schedule. Ma'am, actually, my students want one big picture with you in the Jai Hind pose, because they feel it's a very, very rare moment where they are with the first woman police officer of this country. So if you permit, can we do that?
Yes, please. Let's see how you do it.
Yeah. So, Kanika, let's have the gallery view. And yes, you just tell everyone to come in the Jai Hind pose.
Lovely. Oh, the Hajar saluting.
Let's all salute.
I salute
to you, ma'am. We salute to you.
I salute to you, children. Salute to your spirit within and your purity within. Children are such true purity. I salute you too. Lots of love. And Jai Hind and a very happy Diwali to all of you.
Jai Hind and happy Diwali to you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you. Bless you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Jai Hind.
Thank you.